I cannot tell you how many people ask me, Cooper, what are you doing in the stock market? The answer that I give, no one seems to expect it. I'm waiting for a stock market crash. Now there's a couple of key reasons why I'm doing this, which makes me hold off from buying stocks and instead wait for a crash. Now, let's just get straight into this. The first thing I need to talk about is sky high prices and market cycles. For those who don't know, we are currently less than 5% away from all time market highs. The S&P 500, which gives the best measure for the USA stock market, is sitting at around 3,200 points. That's not far away at all from the peak. Now, a lot of people look at this and think, oh, that's such a good thing. The economy is booming, stocks are up. Surely, investors are happy. And it's true, a lot of investors are absolutely gleaming at how high the stock market is. But investors like Warren Buffett and myself, we look at things slightly differently. We are less happy when stock prices go up and more happy when stock prices go down. Now, for some people, this might sound confusing, but stick with me. What Warren Buffett and I truly focus on is the underlying business. Are they generating more income, more revenue, and growing assets? How is their business model going, and how will it look like in the future? These are the types of things which we hope to go up. But the stock price, we want that to go down as far as possible. This way, we can purchase great, solid underlying businesses for cheap prices. But you might look at me and say, Cooper, yes, that makes total sense, but why aren't you buying stocks now? Why are you holding off and waiting? There is no guarantee of a stock market crash. That is a very good question, but to answer that, I want to go back to talking about the underlying businesses. Right now in the stock market, if you look at a lot of the underlying businesses, you can see that they're struggling. For example, everyone in the travel industry. Nobody is really traveling these days because of the shutdown. This results in every business in the travel industry being affected and losing business, losing customers. I mean, we saw Warren Buffett. He completely sold out of all of his stocks in airline companies. They just lost so much business and so many customers, and the question became, are they worth holding on to? Warren Buffett, he thought not. But then, don't forget, it's not just airline companies, and it's not just businesses involved in the travel industry. Small and medium-sized businesses across the USA have been deeply impacted. I mean, less people have been going for coffees or going out to eat. Less people are going to the movies or the ice rink. Businesses across the USA have lost a lot of customers. Now, what is the flow-on effect from this? It means businesses' bottom lines, they go down. It means the amount of profit that they generally make gets eaten into. Investors like myself, who focus on the underlying businesses, look at this and think, if I'm going to invest in stocks like these, well, at least I want to be paying a cheap price for them. And at the moment, prices are nowhere near close to cheap. As I mentioned before, they're actually close to all-time highs. It puts us investors in this weird situation where the economy is down by 6%, the underlying businesses of stocks are struggling, yet the prices for these stocks are skyrocket high. The value investors like myself and Buffett are just staying on the sideline because of this. And a lot of people will be looking at us thinking, what are you doing? Look at the returns you've missed out on. But they don't understand this one simple principle. And that is, you make money with investing, not through constant buying and selling, but through waiting. Charlie Munger, he puts it best. He said this, you don't make money when you buy stocks, you don't make money when you sell stocks, you make money while you wait. And most people do not have the patience to wait for a couple of years to buy stocks, and that is why so many people fail at investing. A simple lack of being able to wait. Okay, now I want to get into the third reason why I'm waiting for a stock market crash. You see, one of the things that I like to do before investing is see what the experts are doing. What are the likes of Warren Buffett, Ray Dalio, Michael Burry, what are they doing with their portfolios? And when I look at all three of these guys, they seem to have one thing in common. They are very tentative, very iffy, very, dare I say it, bearish on the stock market over the next couple of years. Let's start with Warren Buffett. For those of you who follow him, you will know that he has been a net seller of stocks so far in 2020. He sold out of his airline stocks, sold out of some of his bank stocks, and a range of others. And when he talked about this in his shareholder meeting, he was very cautious with his words on what he thought on the stock market. I've not seen him this cautious for a long time now. But you know, when we look at Ray Dalio, he's not afraid to say what he thinks and make predictions. He came out and he said on a recent TED interview that the 2020 crisis will be bigger than the one we had in 2008 and could be similar to the Great Depression in 1930. I got to be honest, when I heard Dalio speak like this, I was quite surprised that he was so upfront on his thoughts on a stock market crash. Considering that he's one of the experts when it comes to market cycles, I definitely didn't take those words lightly. But lastly, let's talk about Michael Burry. He's the investor who was made famous through the movie The Big Short. That's the movie with Christian Bale, who plays Burry. Essentially, what Burry did was 12 years ago, he saw that the stock market was in a bubble. He shorted the stock market, it popped, and Burry made a ton of money. Now, the interesting, slightly scary thing is that Burry is speaking along similar lines to what he was saying back then. This is what Burry said recently. Index fund inflows are now distorting prices for stocks and bonds in much the same way that CDO purchases did for subprime mortgages more than a decade ago. The flows will reverse at some point, he said, and it will be ugly when they do. Like most bubbles, the longer it goes on, the worse the crash will be. And I gotta tell you, when I hear words like that coming from someone who has a history of predicting market crashes, it definitely makes me think about the way I invest. Hearing all of these experts talk about the stock market in such bearish terms makes me invest more conservatively, and it's one reason why I'm waiting for the next market crash. Anyway, let's finish this off by telling you the final reason why I'm waiting for a crash instead of buying. The reason is, when you buy low, you get much higher returns, and the one thing that you need in order to buy low is cash. So you see, one of the best times to be investing was back in 2009, just after the stock market had crashed. That's when stocks were at their cheapest. If you bought around there, just 12 years later, you would have made over a 300% return. That's more than 4 times your investment. However, if you bought before the market crashed in 2007, your return would have only been just over 100%. That's why it's so important to be patient. Warren Buffett, he has mastered this art of patience. During 2006-2007, he was accumulating a lot of cash instead of putting it in the stock market. A lot of people thought he was crazy, just like they do now, yet in the long run, Warren Buffett won. But in order to benefit from these stock market crashes, you need to have cash available when the markets are down and when a recession is in full swing. That's why you have to be able to save up cash and not be overly tempted by the market when it's at all-time highs. And this is one of the things that made Warren Buffett the king of investing. He learned to invest using the facts instead of using his emotions. It's called acting with equanimity. And at the end of the day, if you look at the facts relating to the stock market in 2020, prices are high, underlying businesses are struggling, and there have been better times to invest. That is why I'm choosing to wait.